some about schools. So if you look for schools, let's see what comes up. And so if you wanted to see a list of schools, you can open up this data set.
So this data set lists all the schools, and so if you want, it provides you some information. And so if you wanted to take it and open it up in Excel or use Google Sheets or anything like that, you can export data here, and you can export it into a number of formats. So you can export a CSV, or Excel, or any other number of formats. Another thing you can do is print out data, or make PDF. Another tool is OData, which Adam will talk about a little bit later, where you can bring data straight into Microsoft Access and Excel and do some work there. There's also an API for those that are technical and want to build it into an application directly. So that's one type of data. There's also map data that you can look at too. So here's a map of the Chicago Public Schools locations. So with this data too, you can export it as a couple different formats, KML, shapefile, and with the map data, you can then bring it into a mapping tool like QGIS, which is an open source GIS tool, or ArcGIS. It can be used then to bring it to applications. So an example of spatial data being used, I'm gonna go to Cook County's data portal, and on here we have a number of data sets, parcels. Look for parcels. So this is all the property boundaries for all of Cook County. This is how taxing works for property. And so you can take this data and mash it up with other data. And so one use of this particular data set was the large lots that work project, which Christopher talked about earlier. So to build largelots.org, they took the parcels from the data portal and then joined that with data from the city of Chicago and some other data sets to make this site, which then allowed people to find vacant properties that they can buy. And so in this example, they used City of Chicago, or Cook County parcels, Cook County address points, City of Chicago community areas, and Chicago city-owned land inventory. So you can take data from multiple places and kind of bring it together. So another feature of the data portal tool is the ability to do some searching and filtering within a data set. So I'm going to bring up Cook County's open data set from Cook County Recorder of Deeds Office, which has information on foreclosures, mortgages, and quick claim deeds that happen throughout Cook County. So this brings up the table has the PIN number, it has an address, and so you can take this and put it on the map. This also you can do some filtering. So let's say you have this list and you just want to only look at mortgages, you can come up and click up here so and drop down, you can filter a column by one data set type, or one recorded document type in this case. Now it's just displaying mortgages. There's another way that you can search or to search within a data set, and that's using the filter tool up here. And with that, you can add multiple criteria. So you can add a new filter condition, and then you know if you're looking for a specific parcel identification number, you can just type it in here, or you can change your criteria. So if you want to search for this filter. So you can clear your column filter here. And so now, if I wanted to include other types of documents, so there's mortgages, but there's also, there's one, so let's use foreclosures. There's foreclosures, so there's data types that are mortgages, but there's also corrected mortgages. So if you wanted to include both, you could change this to download type contains, and then type in mortgage. And so now the search will show both mortgages and the corrected mortgages. You can also add multiple filter queries. So if you then also want to filter it's on a date, so let's only look at recorded dates after let's look at recorded documents this year. So now it's going to pull up all mortgages that have been recorded after January 1st through, in this case, March 27th is the last date on this currently. So if you wanted to save this query, you can save it and send it out to people, and you can do that if you have to create an account. And you can create one account that you can log into and it'll work on the county's website or through Chicago's or City of Illinois. Now I've logged in and I've been able to save this filtered view I've created. So now you've got a URL that then you can send to people or use to bookmark to get at in the future. Data portals are a great source to get data. There's also a City of Evanston, if anyone's outside the city, they also have a data portal. Theirs looks a little different. They also have similar features where you can export data as a spreadsheet. This is Evanston's data portal page, and if you were interested in permits in Evanston, you can click here and then So their data, their page will show permits and liquor licenses in this case, and inspections and violations. You could then take a look, you know, see Chicago has similar building permits. So if you wanted to take a look across multiple municipalities, you can take a look at Chicago's and Evanston's. There are not building permits on Cook County's portal yet. Another thing that you might, so you could look at across the cities and the counties is business licenses. So say Chicago has business licenses on their data portal. And Cook County, there are some registered, certain types of businesses have to register with the Cook County Department of Revenue. So there's data sets here if you were looking for parking lots or gasoline, gas stations, you can find a list here. So large lots is one example of data being used. Project. Project I helped work on a couple years ago, schoolcuts.org. We use data from City of Chicago and Chicago Public Schools and State Board of Education. So there's data that also lives outside of the data portal. And that's kind of something I wanted to touch on too, is that there's a lot of data being added to these data portals, but there's also other places to go to find data. You know, if you're interested in schools in Chicago, Chicago Public Schools has a data-specific page that keeps where they keep a lot of performance data and test data and accountability data and metrics. There was one of the things that came up during discussion earlier today was about facilities and opening schools. There's a page that has a data set listing the school utilization and enrollment numbers. So if you wanted to figure out, you know, where schools were needed or not needed around the city, that data set might be useful. And we used a version of that data set to create schoolcuts.org a couple years ago, which took a look at kind of the state of schools during a proposed mass school closing and relocations. Are there any questions so far?